The Ferrang now become a stronger. The training, the fighting for the right reason to win. This the Thai guy fighting for the money. I'm British thinking. Maybe Thai hard, but British thinking. No, but don't forget, Thailand is always follow England every footstep. Bruce Lee, my idol. And you know that the big boss is in Thailand. You know where is it? My uncle house. That is a national heritage, a national culture of Thailand. Kill. Like a dog, like that. Kill. In Thailand, if I work on the dog, I'll be dead by now.
You're welcome.
I was luckily born in the surname of Surisampan, which is a part of the royal family, Rama the Third. And the family dating back its root come from King Rama the Third. So our family in the past always serving the king in the palace since many, many years, since Rama the First, now it's Rama the Ninth. And my basic living, upbringing, it's just really normal people who just try to make a living. My mom and dad, and we're not, even though we come in the family of the from good background in the past, but I have not rich. And I love martial arts. I love Muay Thai. I was within the Muay Thai every day in the past. It's just really for the educational, for the people who have a bit money and the wealth to do. Muay Thai is before Muay Thai is one of the martial art that learned by the king and the warrior. The people from the past, the palace, learned it for fight in the war. Muay Thai is very important in the past in to bring or to protect the country. And in the peace time, Muay Thai it become part of a sport and martial art. So I have a chance to learn of at the time was the Vietnam War, the Korean and the Army, American Army, based in Thailand. So my teacher was I met the teacher who teaches Taekwondo. At the time it was teaching for the American Army to fight in the Vietnam. Based in Thailand, and take up a lot of time and enjoy it, and take the competition with the Taekwondo, with using the Muay Thai technique to fight against the big American and different people training in the American Air Base. So I was, new, so
didn't know what to do,
no expect, but I using. Kick and the Muay Thai kick and I won. I want to went to the next stage. The next we go to the final. I had to meet up with the Thai fighter to get my master skin. I had to go to fight with him before. That's why I met, because he master skin also have same teacher as me, but he teaching based in Utapau. American guy who quite good. Another time we were. I thought instead of fighting him until he not get hurt, so I drop off. Said you go to fight forward. So I didn't. I think that Master Skin is very good fight. You know, like, good technique. So I said, okay, you can go and go ahead.
That was a conscious decision for you.
Otherwise, you'd be fighting. That's right. Why should be hurt and then? So I dropped out. Thanks. Yeah, because it's no point to fight each other. He might have to hurt and then to fight the guy. Thai. We claim claim teacher, and we shouldn't fight against each other, so okay.
Bonjour, Monsieur Bond.
In 1973, one of the girls in James Bond, Miss Joy, which as you are, who've been drafting the James Bond team coming over to Thailand, wanted to make the film, American Again. The casting, they don't want to see that how we do everything, different thing, different style. But we were saying to him, with the team of Hong Kong people, was all kung fu expert, jumping, some sort, everything like that, and good for the film. But mostly the hand, they use the hand, rather than kicking. So we were saying, oh, we like to be a bit more. At the time, it was like a Bruce Lee coming, and it was spectacular. And what we didn't want to see, just like the hand attack, like a karate thing. So he said the guy casting was a stuntman for the Rotimua standing, with Leslie Crawford. So he said to me that, okay, want to see this guy, what are we doing? So they brought the team of Kung Fu to look at us. And we were training at the time. And me and Toddy were training together, showing up to kick in there. And when they looked at us, said, you want to have a go with us? I said, oh, no, no. So they're impressed, so they wanted to be part of it. We were wishing that we can speak better English, but we were mingling with Britt Eklund, you know, Tattoo at the moment, a guy. Mingling with Christopher Lee, and all, but we didn't know who they are.
No.
Come to the time that a little bit gap 1923, the student revolution in Thailand. Big revolution, the government, the army government would already take over the country for a few years already, and we have a big demonstration of students. Thammasat. Toddy was the chief of the school, student, union school in Thai, in Bangkok, and I'm chief of the technical school in Thakkan. So we all went to Thammasat. It was a real hero in that time. We wanted to get rid of the junta government who've been in power in a long time. So at the time, it was one of the reasons that we got rid of the government, the head of government gone. But a lot of people still under there, still in the power. Finally, because the name, our name, who was the head ring leader of the each school, each thing, is in the book to say that when they're gone, but I gotta get you back, right? This is the list. So my Toddy's father was a special police. He said he know that he said no good to be in here. They said we gotta go out. We have to move, we have to go out to Thailand, to abroad. So we choose, me and Toddy thought, okay, we gotta go to England. We went once to Germany, but we don't know Germany language, don't know anything else. America is too far away, so I thought England is the best place to go. Because we can get we got a student visa together, and we can get study England and get out quick enough. And because we know that if it stay longer, it won't pick up. Oh yeah, we went to study to England. Very very little money. But we have to get a visa to learning 3 months in London. At the time we get to London, 1975. April 15, April 75. As we went down the plane, Starts snowing. What is it? We never seen snow in our whole life. It was so cold. In the 10 o'clock at night, we start stretching. We know what's gonna happen. So much of, you know, every day. And how are you gonna defend yourself on different time? Or how we sacrifice? Or you just said, you to be, we were, the manager himself was impressed with us so much. He said, all the big guy stand there. He said, they know what happened. But they all were coming for smaller ones. So I said, Toddy, what is it? Kill. Like a dog, like that. Toddy, what is it? Kill. And we just go. One week said, we got to go. In Thailand, if I work on the door, I'll be dead by now, by then. But in England, I was lucky because the only fist, bottle, pie pot, it's okay. We can defend that.
One-on-one usually or sometimes?
No. I start with one-on-one, and then two, three, 4 or 5 coach load. At the end, we had fight every day until become a reputation. Said, well, let's go kick the shing today. You know, the people said, they tell like, oh, yeah, the chick, it's a challenge. It's a challenge of the other day. My life is to went to the college and I met my wife, Jill. So, and then I introduced to Muay Thai already, teaching a weekend at the time and do different work, in working in engineering, and then drive taxi. It's all sort, everything just to survive. And then I decided to think that we should do something that to do with home. So I like cooking. My father is good cook as well. So I decided to open the first Thai restaurant in Manchester, Siam Orchid. One of the very first outside Bangkok, outside London. So I set up the restaurant. I get my brother to partner me. Set up everything and cook everything and plan everything. It was a big success in the time, very big success. A good restaurant. And then we opened another one, a bigger one. So I let my brother take care of that. I take a smaller one. We hope we bought the building. We done all sorts. We done a big thing. Also, we have, even within the building, we have the gym on top floor, the accommodation, the restaurant for renting out for Korean food, and our restaurant and Italian food. It was okay. It was. My brother was my real brother. Nick for me. I my younger brother. I brought him to Thailand and to England, and I want obviously he. He worked with me, but he wanted to be his own thing as well. So he talked to some of work, to different people. I set up different things. By any time, Farah coming to train, I would teach him a few things and get him to be a teacher in Bristol. He was a kung fu background guy with a student, some of work, I don't know. And then it was good. It was train hard, coming to train, waking up to train every night. And also, by that time, we have restaurants where we're finding a lot of work to do. So, anyway, we set up the school in Bristol, probably met you and opened that. So, it's a part of the growing up promoting Muay Thai in there.
Yeah, you get a very good run
with that. Yes. Good kicking. It's tall, long, and tall. Big colors. The Farah now become stronger. The training, the fighting for the right reason to win. This the Thai guy fighting for the money. There is their job. It the training, their work. The Farah guy, their hobby, their enjoyment. They want to be the winner. The criteria, the thing of different. A Thai is not because he fight every week, every month. You know, it's strong anyway, that okay. But sometimes this is a dull pitfall type boxer this day. They don't train to fight five rounds. They train to fight only three rounds. Well, after the five rounds, they do four rounds coming up to five from beginning. He can knock the Thai guy out with the pan or hurt the guy. And when he's not preparing, underestimate. Shame. They should never take it down at all. Because of the land, it belonged to the king's property. Thank you. Yeah. And no, it wasn't looking to the king. The organizing, the thought that they can organize the city, it's the city ground, middle of city. It's lots of money, a lot of hiding in it. And then they told me, I want to take it down, I want to build up the big shopping center and all this and that. Yeah, but belong to the king, belong to the crown, the people, you know, belong to the king, the crown people, who manage it by the crown property. Okay, so this will have interest on it. I said, why? Like, I don't think like a Thai. Thai is thinking, well, move away from there. Don't forget about the old one, the old dirty thing anyway. And move away from there, they get paid to move a lot of money. But I thought that is a national heritage, a natural culture of the diamond people. And I said, how can you mock everything down like that? It won't be. Close it, develop a little bit, make it to a museum, something like that, better. Wow. We get more money to, for visiting than to build money on it. Yes. I was, I said,
so, I mean, maybe because you stayed in England such a long time, you think a little bit about
it. Yeah, I think I like Farang. But at the time, and after, purposely, they didn't study that this land belonged to, but they want to build a high rise up and send big shopping center. We couldn't do it. Why? Because it's next to the bloody, embassy. They're not allowed to build a big modern toilet shine near the embassy. And that's it around here. I like Bo Khao, but there's some better fighter than that. But you know, Bo Khao is a nice guy.
You met
him? Yeah, I met him. We spoke a few times. He's a nice boy.
Did you ever try to meet Rob Carmen?
Rob Carmen? No. I think I met him briefly, but not to train him. I went to Holland a few times, the fighters as well. What's it called? Tom Haring? He's a promoter of Chaguriki, the owner of Chaguriki camp. He's one of the first guys who bring team to come to fight here. 12 to 22 March 2015, Organizing World Martial Arts Games. World Martial Arts Games. First time in Thailand in the world, organized 10 disciplines. Muay Thai, Pomeran, Kickboxing, Jiu Jitsu, Karate, Kung Fu, Pancasila, Eskrima, Thai Sword Fighting, different things. My idol. And I grew up at the same time as Bruce Lee time. Yeah? Bruce Lee only before, as you know, I was training in Taekwondo before my master Korean. He only talked about Bruce Lee in 1970s. And we were young at the time. We were always up coming, talk about Bruce Lee. This guy can be very good in this one. I said, who is he? We don't know. And you know that the big boss is in Thailand. You know where is it? My uncle's house.
Really?
In Pak Chong.
But
yeah, in that the Bruce Lee come to Thailand and do the film in Big Boss, and they come against the local boxing, the Thai boxer boy. And get the ass kicked from the Thai boxer boy.
Really?
Yeah.
So it's a lot of
yeah. And that's why they start changing. I look what I'm doing. ไอ้ลูกผมที่ไปที่ที่อ่ะ
โตเกียวที่อ่ะ
ไม่ใช่ที่ที่ปักช่อง
ที่ปักช่อง
หรือกล้องหรือกล้องมาหนึ่ง
I was
very I heard about it I was actually there
so Bruce got the ring with the time
oh no they were I think they were training what I heard I wasn't there and I can't confirm it but the people that said that the Bruce Lee want to have a go or try with the time Muay Thai guy.
Yeah.
And you can see the style changing after that.
Yeah.
It starts stand long anymore. You go.
Yeah.
That put burger. Yeah.
So
Yeah. Different photograph. And that the house on
this is another Bruce Lee thing.
Yeah. This is in the place that we the big boss house. This is a lot of jumping around.
So that's the what?
Yeah.
That's the little temple that Bruce is fighting in the next year.
That's right.
How did that happen?
What did they choose
that? I don't know. Because my uncle told me to say, oh, Some guy came out. Want to use the lawn to do.
Some Chinese dude.
But, and at the time we didn't know who this guy was. Nobody had heard of Bruce Lee, you know that. I think his move was inspiring everybody. Inspired. That's one of the reasons that Taekwondo was coming out well, because he kicked the way to kick the same way that we train. In the past we do train like that. No, Michael. Michael permitted him to take in the film all that house.
I just love the concept.
Yeah. They told me that this Chinese guy wanted to borrow the front lawn to do the filming.
Bruce Lee wants to have a front lawn.
Yes. No, he was unknown. And I believe it's the ice factory is in the Bak Chong, not far away from the town. Go to the town. Let me think and find out. I don't know where I found it.
Last question. I reckon once you lose a celebrity fight, or even winning,
we all are big Lelan.
Yes.
He's bigger than me now. I thought it would be.
I reckon that would be a sellout. That would be on YouTube, a million hits, you have to wait for the site. Would you have gone to the death? They're
With a glass. I don't think white people would be around. We like sumo
wrestling guys. Yeah, white tie strip sumo. Brilliant.
Okay. Anyway. Alright, that's good. Okay, thank you.